Sorry, man. You mind if I
join you? Definitely, bro.
Shot, man.
Yo, dude, let me ask you something.
Yeah, sure.
How did you become a millionaire? Because you look like you got some money, bro.
I wasn't always this rich. It started when my dad left us because I was born too ugly. Mom eventually got depressed and became addicted to spur sweets. The spur bills started piling up because we only went there for the spur sweets and we eventually couldn't afford basic things. Eventually we got chucked out of our house, had to live under the second bridge on the M5 close to Access Park, where we used to watch people through the fence buy shoes for half price, and we used to hope that we could be there one day. Mom couldn't shake the spur sweets habit, but we couldn't afford spur sweets this time. So we had to have leftover spur sweets. You know, sometimes you suck on the spur sweet and you just don't want to finish it, so you spit it out. My mom was the one who got those spur sweets. Anyway, fast forward 5 years, we got out of that situation. Mom met a guy called Tom. Tom wasn't a very bright guy, but Tom was there. The problem with Tom is, Tom would forget that he needed to wear clothes. My girlfriend didn't like that at the time. Gave me an ultimatum one day when Tom came out naked and told me we had to leave. We ended up leaving my mom's house to go find an apartment. I couldn't afford a normal apartment. It was a flea bag hotel full of roaches. Our friends never came because most likely of all the roaches. But the roaches was our friend now. Eventually, she had enough. She couldn't take it anymore, the girlfriend. She left me because I couldn't give her what she wanted because I had a small penis. Still, I have a small penis. So there I was, no girlfriend, living in a flea bag hotel. Tom's probably walking out naked. Mom's still probably addicted to spur sweets. And then it hit me. It actually physically hit me. They broke into my home. They hit me. They kidnapped me. And they put me in the back of a white minivan. Actually, my face was covered, but because I lived under the M5 bridge for all those years, I knew exactly what this van was. The number plate sounded like a CA521-748. That's what the number plate sounded like, yeah. So luckily, I managed to get free, knocked the guy in his head. But anyway, I digressed. So I became a millionaire. I just played the lotto and won some the money.